Hello students, welcome back to our online biology classroom. Today we are moving to our second chapter, food through digestive tract. In this chapter we will learn what do you mean by digestion and how digestion process takes place in human being. Let's start our topic with nutrients. We get nutrients required for life activities from the food we eat. There are 6 important nutrients. The most important one is the carbohydrate. Function is it helps in energy production. Second important nutrient is the protein. It includes pulses, milk, chicken, egg, nuts, dal, etc. Its function is it helps in the formation of tissues. It also helps in the growth and also repair the body. Fat is also an important nutrient. It also helps in the production of energy. Next one is the vitamins and minerals. It controls and regulates physiological activities. For the smooth functioning of body activities, water is very much essential for our body. So water facilitates physiological activities. Now write this one in your notebook. Food materials we eat are not absorbed as such by our body. It is taken by the process called digestion. Digestion is a process of converting complex food materials into simple absorbable form. Now look at this video. Digestion begins inside the mouth. The teeth break down the complex food particles into smaller particles and these food mixes with the saliva. Then the food through the pharynx, it reaches the esophagus. The esophagus pushes the food towards the stomach. And in the stomach, there undergoes chemical reaction. From the stomach, the simplest food particles reaches the small intestine and the nutrients reaches the whole parts of the body. The undigested food reaches the large intestine and then to the rectum. Digestion process starts with teeth. The structure and arrangement of teeth is suitable to masticate or grind the food we eat. There are 4 types of teeth. One is incisor, second one is canine, third one is premolar, and fourth one is molar. Incisors. Incisors are the sharp teeth at the front of the mouth that bite into food and cut into smaller pieces. Both the children and adult have 8 incisors. Second one, canine. Canines are the sharp, pointed teeth that sit next to the incisor and look like fangs. Both children and adult have 4 canines. Next one is a premolar. Premolar are bigger than the incisors and canine. They have many ridges and help chew and grind up the food. Adults have 8 premolars. Molars are the biggest of all the teeth. They have a large flat surface with ridges and they allow them to chew food and grind it. Adults have 12 permanent molars. Next, our topic is structure of the tooth. In the diagram, you can see the cross section of canine and molar. All the teeth has similar in structure. The teeth has 3 parts. The upper part is called the crown. The middle portion is called the neck and the lower part is called the root. First one is the enamel. The front portion of the teeth is called the enamel, which is white in color, and it is the hardest part. Because of this hardness, we can bite all the substances, and also it has dead tissues. Second one is the dentate. It is the living tissues which forms the tooth. Third one, pulp. It is the soft connective tissues seen in the pulp cavity. Here, blood vessels, lymph duct and nerve fibers are seen. Third one, cementum. Calcium containing connective tissues that holds the tooth in the socket of gum. It is called the cementum. Let's recall what we learned today. Today we discussed about different types of nutrients, how digestion process take place, different types of teeth, and structure of the canine and molar. Watch the videos, learn your portions well. See you next day. Bye.